lovely.
Hello, everybody. Thanks for coming down for our birthday party.
Girls, we're not easy. You're not that easy too. Sure, we got problems. Sometimes they land on you. The most marvelous man with his heart in his hand will cause you some grief someday. Oh, girls, we're a minefield. Don't get we like chocolate. We can be hard or soft. The most sensitive guy with the sweetest advice will cause you some grief someday. Then it's all up to you to decide what to do on the strength of what he's got to say. Oh, girl, you know that we love.
But that's from our current Roadcase album. I tell you what, I've played here with this band and other people over the years. I always get a bit nervous when I get on stage at the Basement. Always. I took some precautions. I got into town this afternoon, went to the All Night Medical Centre, and he said, "Greedy, as long as you don't resort to drugs, you'll do all right. Don't take drugs, but in that room back there, don't get into that den of bonging iniquity."
No.
Don't do that. He said, just before you go on, just make sure you dip your genitals into a lovely warm slurry of concrete and clay.
You to me are sweet as roses in the morning. You to me are soft as summer rain and dawn. I love you, shit. That's something. walks in the street. The concrete and the clay beneath my feet begin to crumble. All around, I see the purple shade of evening. On the ground, the shadows fall, and once again, you're in my arms. So tenderly, the sidewalks in the street, the concrete and the clay beneath my feet begin to crumble. My love will never die. Concrete and the clay beneath my feet begin to crumble. My love will never die. We'll see the mountain tremble before we say goodbye. My love and I will be in love eternally. That's the way it's meant to be. That's the way it's meant to be. That's the way. Let's go now.
Shell. Must be here, got lost now. Something is missing.
Something is missing.
All the people around here are too bony for kissing.
I'm bony for kissing.
I was lying in bed when I woke up dead. I was cool, but not too calm. Must have stolen my soul through a photograph or a jungle voodoo charm. Must be here, got lost now. Something is missing.
Something is missing.
All the people around here are too bony for kissing.
I'm bony for kissing.
We dance around the gravestone and we drag the chains around. We clatter and clank, chatter and skankle when we get down to see to the ground. Always be a chair for you in the corner of my heart. A table for two, for me and you, for as long as we're apart. Must be here, got lost now. Something is missing.
Something is missing.
All the people around here are too bony for kissing.
I'm bony for kissing.
We dance around the gravestones and we drag the chains. Cradle to grave, back to the cradle again. 600 dumb creatures to make up the souls of 10 men. My spirit got lost now, something is missing.
Something is missing.
All the people around here are too bony for kissing.
Bony for kissing.
My spirit got lost now, something is missing. Get lost too. Voodoo jungle, voodoo.
much. Thank you for cheering a song about dead people. We'd like to take a more optimistic slant. We don't want to slide down that slippery slope into... that's in Dog Trumpet area. The Dog Trumpet like to look at some of the murkier sides of life. They're happy in their New Zealanders to wallow in the dark centre. They won, okay, they won all right. 2 points. Oh, it's close. And I tell you, I don't think Reg or Pete or Mike would have known the result of the test match tonight. Because being New Zealand musicians, they know nothing at all about sport. They have no interest in it. Where was I? Sorry. Back to being on the most optimistic man in Australia, ladies and gentlemen, Martin Plaza. The guy with a never say die, the can-do attitude. The man who gives us, if you leave me, can I come too? That's a lovely cheery take on it. Martin also, as well as being optimistic, he can be a bit mechanistic too. We'd like to do his latest song on mechanistic philosophy entitled One Thing Leads to Another.
Better.
the future. How can you just throw them away? Just think about the love we spend together. I think about it every day.
A bit of a dodgy start, but we got the hang of it at the end. It's only new, that one.
I tell you what, I've had to buy a couple of truckloads of water lately. We still hasn't rained much around Sydney, you know. We'll be on water rationing soon. But I just wanted to draw your attention to the fact that the Northern Rivers District of New South Wales has had pretty good rain. They've had some pretty good rain up there, and it's been... Bellin, and that's right, it's not far from there. There's the problem is that the cows up there are not eating the beautiful lush grass in these wet paddocks. No, they're still insisting on eating the magic mushrooms that come out of the steaming manures that they produce. And unfortunately, these cows are still being milked, and the milk is going straight to the primary school children in Mullumbimby. It's a crisis.
Right, man.
see looking through those tears. And don't you know you're worth your weight in gold? I can't believe that you're alone in here. Let me warm your hands against the cold. A close encounter with a hard-hearted man who never gave half of what he got. As they do, it's that you'll never be more. That's a shame, cause you got the lot. Hey, yeah, you with a sad face, come to my place and live it up. Crying for us, give it up. If you smile for walls that fall down on all the people in the speak of joy. But if you left, you'd level this town. Hey, lonely girl, that disappoint. Hey, yeah, you with a sad face, come up to my place and live it up.
That might catch on, I think, that song.
Thanks. Cheers.
I wouldn't have made one of those Irish whiskies myself, to be sure. Whoa, no, don't give it all to me. That's not bad.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll take you now to Pervert. I'm going to say to Pervert's Paradise. Now taken out of Surfers Paradise, New South Wales.
Don't care what anybody says about you, no. Gonna stick to you like super glue. The stories are like something from a horror show. Your so-called friends have got it ill for you. Let's go to paradise. Find a place where we can talk forever.
time that you spend wasting your own when you should be wasting mine. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We'd like to do a song now written by Dave Barraclough, our bassist. He's been with us for 5 years or so now, I'd say. Probably more like nine.
Feels like ten.
Dave Barraclough is a man who taught me how to do the cryptic crossword in the back of a Tarago in New Zealand while drinking dry white wine out of a shared glass with five other men of dubious sexual persuasion.
In like New yourself. Zealand.
Try out one of the cryptic crossword. I'll never eat another mutton pie. Is a song described. He thought this song would be perfect for metal as anything when he joined the band. He thought it would be perfect for us. It's called Stretch Marks.
Hang about. Some cute gin. Okay.
Well, I've got stretch marks on my brain. Just trying to figure out your game. I don't understand the rules. Who is who and who's is who. But I'm playing just the same. I got a ticket to a place. Call confusion on my face. A single clue. How can I keep up with you? I'm not even in a race. You tell me I am in the wrong. Then you praise my stupid song. I'm never sure what to say. A nervous breakdown every day. You take no prisoners with me. Tell me I am free, but I will never get away. I'm in love and I'm afraid. Stretch marks on my brain. Just trying to figure out your game. I don't understand the rules. Who is who and who is who. But I'm playing just the same. And you're not gonna let me go till you find out what I know. I don't know a single thing. Take no prisoners with me. Then you tell me I am free.
That's a toe tapper, isn't it?
That's by way of introduction to the duck over there, but we should get him to sing one of his own personal stories about a party he went to in, can I say Albany, Western Australia, or do I have to make up a town like...
Yeah, let's say, Albany, Western Australia. Maybe you could say a party, a hen's party that I was at in the basement.
Right, okay.
No, Albany, Western Australia.
Okay, he's looking for trouble. It's called The Ballad of Narelle, Part 1.
Number 17, Normal Street in Normalville. It's the house of Normal Bruce and Narelle. It's a party, a Saturday and happily. They're celebrating their 7th anniversary. Her best friend Shazza did a hair today, dress supplied by Kmart and layaway. Neil Diamond's the starting on the stereo. Bruce is banning the bangers on the patio. Narelle's spinning from all the G&T she's sunk. Everybody's happy, everybody's getting drunk. Footy mates in the corner of talking cars. Life's good at a party in suburbia. So go to well. Something that she forgot. She needs Bruce. She's looking for him everywhere. She wants Shazza to help her tidy up her hair. Then she finds him down behind the potted plants. Shazza's got her hands down Bruce's pants. She goes pale and still. She drops her drink, she cannot think. But Bruce and Shaz, they separate, testiculate. But she is blind, she only sees adultery. The hurt, the rage, that's her man betrayed. And Shaz, a mess, her breasts are coming from her dress. She covers them. Narelle attacks a violent femme. They fall into the bangers on the barbecue. They roll around the ugly fighters, drawn a crowd, but tearing hair. Potato salad in the air, the rip, the dress. Meringue is crushed in all the mess with chips and cream and words obscene. The shame, the pain, the beetroot stains. So go to well, go to well, go to well, girl, you're giving hell. Go to well, go to well, go to well, girl, you're giving hell.
Sounds like quite a party. I've had a dream for this band. This is our 26th birthday party. We've been together for 26 years and one shape or another. Thank you. That's nothing to be congratulated. It should be pitied, if anything. But one thing is, for 26 years, we've never had our own business card. And I think if I have a dream, we've done a lot of corporate work lately. I'm ashamed to say, no, we love it. We love corporate work. And the one thing that we've noticed is that all these guys at these corporate functions, and the girls too, and even the waiters, they all have their own business cards. So my dream is for Metal as Anything, all the members, to have their own Lazarette's holographic business card. And it's just not an idle wish, because tonight, after you finish here, you are in a great spot here. You've just got to get outside and stand in a darkened doorway and crouch down. And when somebody walks past you've never ever seen before, leap out at them like this, preferably with your Lazarette's holographic business card in your hand, and say, "G'day, I've never met you before." And if you do this, you'll probably get ahead, because the Americans do it. It's called networking, and you can do it with anybody. Anybody can do it, you'll get ahead. Except there'll be one person there you should avoid like the plague. He'll be wearing a pair of Lycra stretch bicycle shorts. He'll have a solarium tan and bonded teeth. Whatever you do, beware of the one they call Mr. Natural.
I don't drink, I don't smoke, I don't sniff, I don't coke. And you ain't, that's me, and that's what should be.
We'd like to And this as our birthday, it's probably the only time we get to play with Reg and Pete every year. We had to invite their band along to play first, so they would come and play with us. And that's a fair trade-off. And we're going to let them have a go. Rats Mabasa, Peter O'Doherty, welcome to the stage. Thank you. Thank you for coming along. We'd like you to join us for a few songs, if you could. I'd like to do a few songs that we don't do all the time.
I think we can manage that.
Well, this is a song from the world's first triple A-sided EP vinyl record, which is called "Metal Is Anything Plays at Your Party." Instrumental.
On a wing and a prayer. What's the next song going to be, Uncle Greedy?
That song about Jim Blackfoot's mate, who died. Okay. His name's Nigel.
The bricks are burning and the harbor's on fire. You're sick of pies and jerks and all your friends are liars. You can talk the baby Jesus down, talk a row away. You weapons every stranger with a handshake. Blood just mostly, you can talk to baby Jesus, he's a man for you. He got a red silk shirt, a very big muscles too. They call him baby Jesus cause he's bigger than a fool. A devil with the sheilas and a dollar with the blood. He's a like a Cadillac, a rattler like a jam. He shot his own falcon and he drives it like a tank.
You can talk to him anytime you like. You can talk to him. Don't go to Europe for a caravan tour. It won't do much of good for you and you and you. Take the great self robot, the Papakura. Talk to baby Jesus, cause he'll tell you what to do. They call him baby Jesus, cause he's bigger than a fool. A devil with the Sheilas and a darling with the blues. He's a like a Cadillac and wrestle like a champ. He's got his own falcon and he drives it like a tank.
We should take you to the very chilly depths of the North Sea. To take pity on well, the bravest animals in creation would have to be the seabirds of the North Sea, who have to dip their tender pink cloacas into sub-zero waters every day and every night, whether they like it or not, because Charles Darwin makes them. We'd like to call these brave little birds. Berserk Warriors.
Oh yeah. Yon is just a Viking. He is very handy with a sword. He loves nothing better than a curtain slashed right through a whore. Mutilation, jubilation, a friendly muscle in a tussle. Oh yeah. I want her to go Viking. She is such a damn near with a spear. She won't wear silk stockings. All the plated garments are her spear. In the fjords, you can hear them. The eerie horns blow. Oh, Viking love show. Bjorn and Donna earn the leisure. They have each other for their pleasure. Says that it's her one a little. A Viking shouldn't mix their work and play. All that blonde hair for them to share. So much plunder it cut asunder. Now we're beyond and time to see each other. It's on a battlefield, not a lover. No. Oh,
Crazy Vikings.
Hey, Rich, would you send that song about the dead bloke, his name Nigel?
Oh, that one, okay.
Oh, by the way, Nigel died yesterday. A quiet guy, he never had too much to say. Seriously ill for a very long time, but he had a good time. Oh, by the way, Nigel died yesterday. A quiet guy, never had too much to say. He didn't keep up his appearance and he never phoned his parents. They were very, very old. They could be so very rude and they would say to their friends, look at him, guilty as sin. Nobody knows what he's on. He's pale as a ghost, he's narrow as a post. He's a prodigal son. We'll miss him when he's gone. Oh, by the way, Nigel died yesterday. A quiet guy, never had too much to say. Well, he's been going downhill, seriously ill for a very long time. But he had a good time. Say to their friend, look at him, guilty as sin. Nobody knows what he's on. Pale as a ghost, he's narrow as a post. He's a prodigal son. We'll miss him when he's gone.
Got a sore hand.
Yeah. I could say something very inappropriate, but I won't even go there.
I'm not used to this rock and roll, Kate.
I think we're with you there, Greedy.
Yeah. It's like osmosis, isn't it?
Yeah. Say no more, nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
Tarago Lang. There's a such a, if you travel around in a Tarago, anybody here in bands who travel around in Taragos know that if you sit, yeah, you know, the Tarago, the jokes are told, that everybody says the same thing. It's about a 9.5 second lapse between each row of seats. You get everything three times. Ladies and gentlemen, here's somewhere it would be very nice to go to in a Tarago. I think you'll probably rent one there too. They're probably quite cheap. It's called Egypt.
Ah. Right.
We'll be right back.
virgin on tenderness. Well, I don't know you very well, but I'd really like to. The time I come, I see you soon. Your firm shore. For Egypt, won't you hold me like I held a map of you? For Ireland, your location from a travel brochure. For Egypt, I need your sophisticated silence. I'm gonna see you soon, and I'm gonna walk on your firm shore. Egypt, won't you hold me in your desert sand? Your tanks and your sand, your interesting stone.
Lovely song, isn't it? I remember we're doing a film clip for that song. We did the film clip out on Colonel Sands, and Wrench, it was Wrench's had to wear a Roman centurion's outfit and ride a horse, and it was he had to actually ride, and he used this pathetic excuse about his son being born in the middle of the clip to get out of riding a horse.
Superb horseman.
He's a very good horse. Look at his legs.
And they were just shutting down the shoot for 20,000 Horsemen with Chips Rafferty. And so we had to wait till they finished doing that.
It's pretty funny, really, because that was Reg's son Darcy was being born then, and then many years later, Darcy ended up doing our website for us. And he was born during our first trip. It's a long, long time between weeks.
What do you mean doing it?
During it, he was born during it. He's doing it. You know, he invented the website. His son invented the computer.
He was born on the, almost on the set.
Almost on the set.
Almost on the set. So we've got one of Pete's ball terrors to do now.
It's got here.
It's one of my personal favourites. It is.
It is, or it's
it
not.
It is. No, it is. It is.
It is. I'd rather not play it, but
it's called I got tit. I got hit. Sexy,
sexy. I got hit. I'm gonna learn, learn, learn. I got hit. I'm gonna burn, burn, burn. Burst my bubble, baby.
Burst my bubble, baby.
That's my trouble, baby. Maybe I've been lazy.
Maybe I've been lazy
for you. Go listen to my words. Let my jokes kiss me in bed. So let's stop. I feed the cat and I feed the dog. Go away, baby. Get up and catch a bus and run out of my car. Stay away, baby. I got hit. I'm gonna learn, learn, learn. I got lit. I'm gonna burn, burn, burn. Burn my trouble, baby.
That's my trouble, baby.
Maybe I've been lazy.
Maybe I've been lazy
for you. No. Listen to my words. Laugh at my jokes. Kiss me in bed. So let's stop. I feed the cat and I feed the dog. Go away, baby. Get up and catch a bus and work out of my job. Stay away, baby. Don't listen to my words. Let my jokes kill me in bed. So let's stop.
For those of you with sight here tonight, the sighted people here tonight will notice, well, I think you'd like to consider why I look more like Santa Claus than Martin does. You've wondered that, haven't you? And I can tell you why. It's because I thought back to my own experiences as a child, and I remember Mum and Dad telling me that I needed to leave out for Santa on Christmas Eve, and I needed to leave out for him a large bottle of beer and a large slice of Christmas cake. Now, I don't think I was the only child in Australia, not to mention the rest of Australasia, the Pacific region, Asia, and the rest of the world. I was not the only child to do this. And because of this, Santa Claus is now in Jenny Craig, and he's in serious drug rehab as well. We'd like to wish Santa all the best with his recovery, and wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
Things you don't want to hear, cause he's in a hurry. Say goodbye. Say goodbye. Santa Claus is drinking gin, trying as you want. Stopped himself from listening, cause he's in a hurry. Say goodbye. Say goodbye. Apocalypse, the special gift. Apocalypse. While Jesus and bright lights in the sky, shining through his window. Santa Claus and Warner One, there's nothing on his radio at Monday time. Say goodbye. Apocalypse, the spans are dim. Apocalypse, tell me when I turn around, smile and send a face. Tell me why, tell me.
I just love a Christmas song.
We'd just like you to do one more. One more, boys. If you could just do one more for us. I know these blokes have got a very heavy schedule tonight.
Yeah.
They're very, very busy people.
Got two more gigs after this one.
I'd like to do a song now about one of Reg's earlier cars in Australia. There's a model, anyway. This is a song dedicated to the spirit of the late, great, valiant Hemi Pater.
Shit, yeah!
Thanks for having us, lads. That was good fun.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Good night.
Hey, can we do this again next year?
Certainly.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cats Dog Trumpet, I think they've got an album out, but they're Pete, certainly they're recording still. They're still recording. You've got your business card there, Pete. Oh, thanks, mate. Hey. He wants me to say, no, they have a really, they're a really good recording band, and they're good at music, and they're great blokes, really, they are. See, that's a $100 bill, Pete. to give a... can you give that to Pete? Thanks. I can't think with that much money in my hand. 26 years ago, we got together, and it's a very unfortunate coincidence that the night when we got together, with the Pete joined the band for the permanently. That's how we take with the start of the band. It happened to be that the night that happened, Elvis Presley had just died that day. And it was very sad for us. Martin painted a big backdrop, a big picture of Elvis, and we did a few extra Elvis songs. We didn't do this one. But we do now feel a bit guilty about it because Elvis died young. He left a fairly young family. And we'd like to do some of his more obscure material to bring in a bit of money to his family because they're going to be struggling. And this one's called Marie's the Name of His Latest Flame.
Her old friend came by today. He's turning over one end of love. He just found and Marie's the name of his latest flame. But he talked and talked and heard him say she had the longest, blackest hair, prettiest queen as anywhere. And Marie's the name of his latest fame. Though a smile, tears inside were burning, wished him luck and then he said goodbye. He was gone, words to get the return. What else was there for me to do but cry? Through a belief, just yesterday, this girl was in my arms and swore to me she'd be mine eternally. And Marie's the name of his latest fame. Though a smile, the tears inside were burning, wished him luck and then he said goodbye. Was gone, the words they kept returning. This was there for me to do but cry. Their old friend came by today. Was standing there, no one in town. Of love that he just found. And Marie's the name of his latest fame. And Marie's the name of his latest fame. And Marie's the name of his latest fame.
Don't you get the feeling that you've done this kind of thing before? You've been kicked in the teeth, but now you're going back for more. You're in. You take a knife in your hand every time you fool around with him. He just no get to you. Why are you going back? You deserve a whole lot better than that. Your memory must be short, or you find it very easy to forgive. You must be a little bit crazy if you think that's how you ought to live. You just no good for you. Why are you going back? You deserve a whole lot better than that. Oh, stop it. You got the chance. Stop it there, or you'll be over your head in a doom well man. He just no good for you. Why are you going back?
Don't you get the feeling that you've done this kind of thing before? You've been drinking cheap. Now you're going back for more and more and more. He's just no good to you. Why are you going back? You deserve a whole lot better than that.
Find her. Got a whole wide world. Got a
rain down here. Me trying to pick up a girl, but all my eyes filling up with these lonely tears. When there's girls all over the world, I should be lying on the tropical beaches there, caressing a woman's skin. And then in a year, or maybe not quite, be sharing the same little skin. Go to the whole wide world, just to find her. To find her, go to the whole wide world, go to the whole wide world, to find out where they hide her. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh yeah!
Say
thanks for coming along, everybody. I'd like to thank you all for coming along to see us play. This is going to be a live DVD. If everything goes down and we can find the material on the tape.
Hang on.
Put your proper instruments on, boys.
That was shit ass.
We'll do a proper song now. There are lots of little plastic water bottles in there filled with urine, I think. That I'll be collecting. They will sell those after the show. You can get a shroud of Turin and a bottle of urine. We'd like to pay tribute now to the difficult life of people involved in farming and primary industry, specifically farming. It's very difficult for people to do this. It's very labour-intensive. The result of it being so labour-intensive, apart from bad hands, is the fact that the farmer has very little energy left to have sex properly at the end of the day. We have a song designed to describe the problem. You have trouble with this, a farmer? Sick farmer? No, it's true. Well, give us a demonstration later on. No, this is how you do it. This is a song called Sweetheart.
We'll try it. We'll see how it goes.
It's like the breathalyzer at the end of the set, isn't it, Ruby?
Yeah, it's a big ask, but we'll see what happens. Because you painted up your lips and rolled and curled your tinted hair. Oh.
to town. It wasn't me that started that old crazy Asian war. I was proud to go and do my patriotic tour. Yes, it's true that I'm not the man I used to be. Still need some company. It's hard to love a man who's laid or a man who's paralyzed. Can't want some needs of a woman your age to treat me out here alive. It won't be long of her saying until I'm not around. Your love to town. She's leaving now, cause I just heard the slamming on the door. Away I know, I've heard it slam 100 times before. If I can move, I get my gun and put her in the ground. Take your love to town. All over. For God's sake, turn around. I'm not the only one.
See you next year.
I'd like to thank Darren and DB and Drew and all the blokes and all the girls. Thank you. And Pam and Skip. I hope it gets better.
G'day everybody, here we are at the basement where Metal Is Anything are about to record a live digital video disc, which is our first foray into the medium of flat recording. And we'd like to, we'd like to be interviewed by somebody, but nobody's turned up. But we've put together a list of questions to ask ourselves, to refresh ourselves about our past, so that you will know who we are and what we do. First question, Mark?
This is Dave Graney is evidently quoted as saying, "Metal as Anything are unique in the Australian cultural scene because they seem to be able to exist in a form outside time and space." Greedy, what did he mean by that?
But he comes from Mount Gambier, which is a small town. I don't know. He's from the country. He's got a new way of looking at things. I mean, we exist outside of time and space because the time is we're still here.
Mm.
And we're in this space, which is the basement, which is below ground, which means that we are becoming an underground band, gradually.
Yeah. I think he's right about that we do exist
outside.
Outside time and space.
Time and space and outside supermarkets.
I often feel I'm outside time and space.
Outside the pub.
Outside.
Outside the Tarago, outside. Trying to get in, waiting for the drummer.
Yeah, well, always outside some kind of space.
Yeah. That's pretty well. We've covered that pretty well.
Yeah. Now, and the next question here, you might like to address that, put that one on me.
Okay, I'll put that one on you.
And it is, where did it, so you say to me, Martin, where did it all start?
Okay. So, Martin, when?
Can you read that or not?
Oh, I put my glass.
Because, I mean, I don't mind reading them for you.
Okay, you read it to me and I'll ask you the question.
I'll ask you the question. Greedy,
where did
it all start?
Martin, where did it all start?
It started in about 1978 or so, I guess, when Reg and I used to
before then.
77?
You have to be before 77.
Okay.
This is 26th year.
Mm. Yeah. Well, Reg and I used to just sort of jam around a bit and it just kind of snowballed from that. People started wandering in and joining up, and next thing we know, we're on a pool table at the Unicorn Hotel in Paddington every Monday night. And then before we knew what had happened, we were on Countdown.
Yeah, it's funny. And it's funny you should mention the pool table, because we have one right in front of us at the moment. If you could imagine a whole band on a pool table this size, every Monday night playing on a pool table this size, you know what you're going to get? I mean, we put down a few copies of the Herald, but everybody's...
A few phone books.
A bit of
chipboard over the top.
But those Cuban heels are in fashion then, so that it was a shocking table to play on during the week. We have the drum kit over on one side, but basically everybody was standing up there. It was probably the worst pool table in the whole of Sydney.
Well, it was by the time we'd finished with it anyway.
Yeah, the Unicorn Hotel in Paddington.
Yeah, and because we had such a tiny, primitive rig, we were singing through our guitar amps at the time. We literally, the whole band, except for the drums. The drums were on the floor, and the whole band, with all the amps and mic stands, were all on a table this size. But we're not very big people. We were smaller then, too, because we've porked up quite a bit since then.
But I tell you what, one of the things that was handy was the fact that at the art school that we attended, Martin was in the sculpture course, and so he had access to welding materials. And so he'd weld our mic stands out of bits of railway sleepers, and they fitted quite nicely into the pocket of a pool table.
Had a nice
sort of
Giacometti sort of Gaudi sort of look, didn't they?
Yeah, it's very good. Yeah. I'm sure that the viewers will know Giacometti and Gaudi, because that's the kind of audience we attract, the very cultured, artistic style person.
Now, the next question here, Greedy, whose idea was the band's name?
Well, this is a very difficult question because we don't really know, do we? Mm. There's a story that goes that our myth of it is that we didn't have a name for ourselves, and somebody was doing a poster for a show that we were playing at, and he asked us, what do we call ourselves? And we apparently said no, and he said, I leave it with me. and then we were walking down the street a couple of weeks later, and there was a poster saying, dance, such and such and such a place and time, mental as anything. And Bird turned to Bart and said, wait a minute, I thought we were playing there. And then the horrible truth dawned on us that Mental as Anything was going to be our name. And it's quite funny, really, because we were playing in Austin, Texas, in a club, and there weren't that many people. It was midweek, and these young guys down the front, sitting at one of the tables down the front, saying, play some Judas Priest, play some Judas... I can't do a Texan accent, but play some Judas Priest. Apparently what had happened was they got the name mixed up in the translation, so in the local gig guide it said Metal as Anything. We were getting letters of complaint from Chicago saying that they thought it was being unfair to people with intellectual disability. It was nothing of the sort. Americans got to get a sense of humor.
And then there was another bar in Houston where we played, and they were very apologetic that we didn't go over better because they said we were a bit too country for Houston, a bit too country and Western. So worked that way. Anyway, where were we? Signing radio in 1978, things moved quickly for the band. Yeah, we've already been over that. We're on Countdown before you could say Bob's your uncle. Martin, that's me. First hit in the song process, having four writers in the band.
I think I should read that. Which question is it?
Did the songwriting process come easy for you, both with having four writers in the band? Oh, to both of us.
Yeah.
Did it come easy to you, Greedy, the songwriting process?
No, it never does. You, as long as you don't know how hard it is, you can just keep writing. That side of it's easy. If you don't know how hard it is, and then just write the songs, don't you? Then
I find sometimes it's easy and sometimes it's hard.
But sometimes it's easy that there are four songwriters in a band, because it means that there's always plenty of songs to be done. There's always, without resorting to cover versions. A question to both Martin and Greedy. That's Martin on Greedy. What was it like when Mental as Anything toured the US and Canada with Men at Work in 1982 and 1983? I'll hand that over to you, Mark.
Oh, where do I start?
82.
It was like a bit of a blur, to be honest. And we went to a lot of places, and we spent a lot of time in big buses with hangovers, working every night, and just lounging around, with hangovers pretty much most of the time.
Well, there was a lot of activity. I think we did about 15,000 miles of driving in a couple of months. We did lots of shows. We found it was very strange that we'd had a bit of a hit in Canada, so they knew about us, and they didn't know about us in America, but we found that the Canadians understood our sense of humour a bit better. Though we weren't trying to be funny, but we're not intentionally funny. But then you play one night, you'd be playing in London, Ontario, and then the next night you'd be driving 50 miles away into America, and Americans just didn't get it. They just did not get it. So I think we worked out that there is a Commonwealth sense of humour. I think that's where that's why we. A lot of Australian bands do quite well in Canada and New Zealand and
vice versa.
Pakistan.
Yeah.
Pakistan was a Commonwealth country, I don't think.
Tonga.
A fine cricket bat manufacturer. Tonga, yeah. We haven't toured there.
I'm keen to, though. It's a lovely country. I've been there a few times.
On the cruise ships.
Yeah.
Oh, don't talk to me about cruise ships. I remember playing on a cruise ship when I had my arm broken. That was just shocking. The band was playing on a cruise ship, and I had my arm in plaster, and I was in agony. The only way I could keep myself together was by drinking lots of duty-free liquor. And then the ship got hit by a giant cyclone, and that's Martin wants us to go back on a cruise ship, but that's for the next DVD.
No, I'm a salty old sea dog.
Salty old sea dog. Okay. Further hits, singles and albums followed, and in 1986, the soundtrack Crocodile Dundee gave the band hits in the UK/Scandinavia/somewhere else. Why didn't you tour overseas to follow up the success?
We sort of did a bit.
We did a bit.
We did a few of the festivals in Europe, and we were based in London there for a while.
We did an intensive tour of the Midlands.
So we did actually We milked it as much as we could at the time.
But we were starting probably to tone down our overseas commitments due to the arrival of family members.
Like, yes.
We were starting to breed. The Metal as Anything were breeding. And we didn't want to be a band that spent their whole lives on the college circuit in America, because that would have killed us.
Yeah, it would have. Another successful soundtrack with Yahoo Serious in 89 and your cover of Rock and Roll Music. Whose idea was it to record that song? It was Yahoo Serious's idea to record that song. And I wasn't real keen on the idea because I, you know, like most people, I'm a huge Beatle fan. I love everything they do pretty much. And I didn't think we could really improve on their version of it. But because he was, you know, a fan and we'd become quite friendly with him through the, just be at gigs and stuff, we decided to have a crack at it. And I thought it was okay, but it was a big hit, which really surprised me. So it was a bit of a throwaway thing, really, but so I was quite surprised when that took off, that song.
I think it's quite good. And with Mentals over the years, though, we've never been frightened to do cover versions and release them as singles. I remember our first trip to Melbourne would have been in our very early days. We were really scared of going to Melbourne because in Melbourne, cover versions, people who did cover versions, they were frowned upon. But people liked it. We were going and playing Monkey songs and things like that. People liked that. And we released Working for the Man, which was a Roy Orbison song. But Martin tarted it up a bit and turned it into something that was more suitable for us, I guess, but we like to do covers occasionally.
Yeah. Now, in the early 90s, Mentals had another hit with Mr. Natural and sell-out tours and albums with the original lineup. How did you maintain no changes over 22 years?
That's a very good question. I think you should be talking to our therapists, really. I think that question is very hard. And we've put up with a lot from each other over that time. We've put up with some very, very poor behaviours. And I think that because we weren't career musicians, that got us through it a lot. I think, boys and girls, if you're thinking of starting bands, make sure you enjoy what you're doing. You're not trying to be really successful at it. Because if you try and be successful...
It's a recipe for disappointment.
Disappointment, disaster and penury, which is a word for me. Yeah, no money.
Oh, is it?
Penury.
Just another word for pornus.
Pornus, yes, pornus, as opposed to porno. Penury is the porno of pornus.
Right. That was a pretty good effort staying to, you know, the original lineup for 22 years, and we let Pete and Reg have a life after 22 years. But you know, we've got a couple of new boys now, so we're continuing to travel around and make records. And Pete and Reg are here right as we speak, so we catch up with them regularly, and we're doing a gig with them tonight, so, you know.
I think it's pretty good.
Kind of like part of the extended family, I guess, in a way.
We've got that. First of all, Pete found his own replacement in Duck, or Dave Barraclay found his own replacement. He said, look, I've got to get out of this.
It's killing me.
I'll have to...
What?
I told you not to eavesdrop. Everybody gets their chance. No, we found Duck in a New Zealand remainder bin. Now, he was playing with a New Zealand band called The Exponents, who are the sort of band that when you play with, they just people sing along to all their songs. And Duck was one of the, used to stand out the front and play all the guitar, but he wanted to play bass with us, so he's a bassist. And Mike Kahn, he's a proper Kiwi. He's because Reg and Pete originally from New Zealand, so we
so need he's our third proper Kiwi in the band.
They need that sort of Kiwi sensibility, because Kiwis are very strange. They're like no other people on earth, and you need at least one in a band to give it. And the good thing about Mike is he hates sport, doesn't know anything about it. He's an absolute cracker guitarist. He's a good bloke. But we should actually let a few of the other blokes tell you the story. So we'll continue this a bit later on. And just wait. Have you heard any of our performance yet? Have you seen the way I'm dressed? Oh, that's pretty good. That suit was bought in Hong Kong. It's a tailor-made job. It's solid polyester. And when I come off the show, after the show, I wear it straight to the shower. Put a bit of shampoo over it, rub it over the top, rinse it down, and Bob's your uncle is ready for the next night's work. Martin takes a bit more trouble with his clothes than I do.
Yeah.
Thank you.
See ya. Duck, Mike, you were in a very successful band in New Zealand prior to the Mentals.
Yes, I was. I must point out, though, that I'm not a Kiwi. I actually hail from Queensland. I used to call it catching the bus to work. I used to commute over to New Zealand about once a week, once a fortnight. And that was actually where I met the Mentals. They played an open-air festival in about 95 or 96, I think. And we sort of had a few cups of tea after the event. And my name came up as a replacement when Pete decided to leave. Sorry, does that answer the question?
Yeah, that's very good. Very comprehensive. Okay.
Now read out the question for you.
Should I do one of mine?
Yeah, and I'll repeat it.
Mike, the newest member of the band, you also came out of a very successful New Zealand band.
Mike, the newest member of the band, you also came out of a very successful New Zealand band.
Yes. Interesting you should bring that up.
Quite a few, actually.
I was, for a period of time, I was with Dragon. I played with them, recorded the Bondi Road record, and then played with them for a few years, and then I rejoined the band in the final tour before Mark unfortunately got sick and died. I've played with a lot of other Kiwis actually over here, funnily enough. People like Jenny Morris and Margaret Illich.
Yes,
thank you. Yeah. Okay, so your turn again.
Okay.
Mentals album Beetroot Stains, recorded in 2000, featured the single Stretch Marks, which you wrote and co-produced. Tell us a little about it and tell us about Fine Lines.
You've got a rather wooden interviewing style, I must say, Mike, but we'll tell you about it anyway. The album Beetroot Stains came, it was just after I joined the band. In fact, I was still going back and forth between New Zealand, and I was playing in the New Zealand band and the Mentals at the same time. And we started Beetroot Stains at around that time. And what had happened was that I'd played the guys some of my writing that I'd been doing at home, just with a little bit of home recording. And they actually said that they wanted me to record the album. In other words, engineer it, which I'd never, ever done before. So it was a bit of a learning curve. And Stretch Marks was just one of the songs that I wrote it, and Martin heard it and said, hey, I want to sing that. So it was a nice sort of entry into the band to know that the new writing was openly received.
And Duck is actually a wonderful songwriter and producer, I have to say.
I'm sorry, I'll take that back about your interviewing style. And
yes, so I've got one more to do, so. Okay. This is for me, okay? The new album, Roadcase. I could put your glasses on here.
I'll put my glasses on so I can actually read it. Yeah. Mike, the new album, Roadcase, features one of your songs. What was it like having your song on a Mental as Anything album?
It was wonderful, and the interesting thing, I think, was that they were making the record just as I was learning the set, and I like to think that my song, Idiot Dance, is a bit like putting all the Mental as Anything songs in a blender and seeing what comes out. I think it's got a lot of the essence of the early stuff, because I was basically listening to the tracks over and over in the car, learning them.
So it's like a puree.
It's a puree. It's a mishmash and a puree.
Right.
Yep. Your highlights.
You want highlights of being in the band?
It must be, yeah.
I'd have to say the first highlight for me was realising that the band and I had extremely compatible drinking styles, very similar pre-show, during show and after show drinking habits. That's about it, really, I think.
I wouldn't call it a highlight, but I suddenly discovered how many Irish bars there are around Australia when I started playing with this band. I think an interesting question would be to say, how did it come about that I joined the band?
Oh yeah, Mike, how did it come about that you joined Mental as Anything?
Well,
this is this really seedy rock and roll story, this one.
Yes, well. My daughter had just started at Newtown Performing Arts High School, and I was at the open day, and Duck was there. His children were there as well, and Duck said...
And I said, hey, I might have a gig for you, Mike.
And I said, great. And so it's actually, I've got to say, it's the first
rock
time...
Rock and roll.
First time I ever got a gig out of a school orientation day, so... There you go.
Both songwriters with Mental as Anything and founding members, was it a natural progression to form Dog Trumpet around 1991? No, it was an unnatural progression.
Well, I wish we actually had an interviewer who could ask these questions, because it sounds really weird that
you
were just saying this.
Don't you like the way I asked?
Well, it just doesn't sound natural, and you know, it sounds like you're...
I said it clumsily.
You did say it clumsily. Your enunciation was a little bit off.
Anyway, it was quite... I mean, the Dog Trumpet, mainly, I guess we did sort of quieter songs, really. It's more of a folk sort of pop band, whereas the Mentals, because we were a live band, I mean we did the odd quiet song of the Mentals, but you had to do lots of fairly up tempo sort of songs that you could actually play live. So with Dog Trumpet, we could actually do, you know, quieter, folkier stuff that we wouldn't probably ever go at with the Mentals.
I mean, it was also that we had four songwriters in the Mentals, and
loads of spare songs.
So too many spare. Everybody had spare songs. So I think there was a stage where, you know, they start to accumulate, and you either let them just rot on the shelf, or rot on a new CD or a new vinyl record. So
songs dissolve eventually, don't they?
They do dissolve. Okay. Memories dissolve, and that's probably fairly common to most people, especially in the rock and roll industry. It's
they get mouldy, like
they do get mouldy. Probably. Yeah, and you know, if they had some kind of mould kind of spray or something, it'd be quite good for bringing memory back. Would be great, but doesn't seem to be the case. So we had to get those songs out, and once we'd made one album, we just sort of kept it up, and a few years later we did another one. And
we kept doing it, because I think Dog Trumpet went concurrently with the Mentals for about another 8 years or something.
And
the other guys had bands on the side at various times too, so we were all kind of doing it.
It was extremely competitive too, because we were of course trying to outdo the Mentals and sell a lot more.
All the side bands were competing, yes, that's right.
Yeah, but the Mentals was just too powerful in the end. They kept on outselling all the side projects, which is, you know, very...
Very
unfortunate.
They won the rock contest in that respect. Okay,
the rock contest.
That's enough of question one. I'm sick of that question. Yeah, let's go on to question two.
Give us another one.
Reg and Peter are renowned for your artwork. That's our artwork, not
Oh, you're talking,
talking to myself here.
Yeah.
Both with the band and Mambo, did you ever consider giving up Mentals and Dog Trumpet and concentrate on your love of art?
We sort of did. We did both. We also continued with the music.
But I don't think either of us would like to give up music altogether.
No, I can't do that. We both stepped out of the Mentals about 3 or 4 years ago, so that we could concentrate on the artwork and the painting, and Reg has been doing the Mambo kind of the graphic stuff, as well as having exhibitions for years. So it was just getting to be too hard with the constant travel and the Mentals, you know, continue that right the way through from really 1979 right through to still doing it, still going away and packing the suitcase and, you know, getting on the road. So we decided we just had to sort of, we just didn't have enough time to do both properly. So this way we're just sort of still making music, but doing it quietly at home in our bedrooms and recording it at home in a little home studio. And so we've got a bit time, more time to do the music in a very low-key, slow kind of way, and lots more time for the art.
In an old man kind of a way.
In an old man sort of, you know, in a sort of
slow,
incontinental kind of way.
Incontinental kind of way. Okay, well, that's good, because question three, we've just kind of answered it.
Really. Oh, did we? Oh, that's
sort of answers
that was the expert,
what we were just
it?
Talking about. Yeah, so I'm going to just go past question three.
I'm going to
go on to number four. Being back in Mentals as special guest tonight, what's the feeling after over 25 years and your highlights? Well, it's not like we haven't played for ages, the Mentals. We played last year at last year's birthday.
Yeah, the thing of the Mentals, which is pretty weird, is that they continue to, like, it's like a child, it's a big childish kind of outfit.
Yeah, there's always some new excuse for a birthday
they
party.
They have to have birthday parties every single
First
year.
First, it was, I think we had 20 years, we had 21 years, and we had 25.
Yeah, but I think the birthday parties were happening
even
before that. And because the band, officially. We always tabulated the beginning of the Mentals from the day that Elvis Presley died. So it's one of those, most things in rock and roll, you know, they fade, the memory is not very good on just about everything, you know, it gets pretty shaky. But because there's that, you know, Elvis Presley died on August 16, so we remember it and we have birthday parties. And
hey, actually, is that right? Hey, Martin, was that the day that Elvis died, or was it the day we had did the gig just after he died?
The gig was already organised, and it was just a coincidence, and it sort of turned into a wave.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it might not have been the 16th, but it was pretty bloody close. Yeah, he just died. So it's quite a convenient way of remembering a birthday party. It's like, you know, those memory tricks when you sort of remember things that associate with some sort of, you know, like a list of things, you know. So that's our list. It's a list of one rock and roll death.
And as for, well, highlights of the tour, it's hard to think of any specific, like, 10-minute highlights, but the things like touring America were pretty sort of... You remember that?
It was a three-month highlight, wasn't it?
A three-month highlight.
A couple of times.
Yeah. That was, yeah. Things like that.
And even that's a bit sort of...
Quite sort of, sort of almost hazy. Memorable because you're hazy memory.
Oh, no, there was lots of highlights, but, you know, we can't remember them exactly.
We did about 3,000 gigs, so you could say there were 3,000 highlights.
Yeah.
How's that for a diplomatic answer?
Yeah, in the end, it just sort of becomes one huge kind of...
Highlight.
You know, highlight, yeah, sort of soupy highlight.
Soupy highlight that meshes into every other highlight, so I can't really specifically answer that one.
No.
So let's go on to question five.
Yeah, give us another one.
To date, Dog Trumpet have released 3 albums. Your latest is self-titled What's Next for the Dog Trumpet and the O'Doherty Brothers.
What's next for Dog Trumpet and the O'Doherty Brothers?
Well, we're playing tonight, so that's...
Oh, there you go. Well,
specifically,
there you are.
What's next?
We're backing up the Mentals.
Backing up the Mentals tonight.
Because they needed a good support band. And
But we're also doing the occasional gig with our band, Dog Trumpet, and we're recording again.
We're working on a new album.
We've just recorded a cover, actually, haven't we? We've just recorded a cover of the old...
Should we tell them? Should we let this out of the bag, or, you know, the cat out of the bag? I suppose it'd be better, because it's...
Yeah, we'd better.
Otherwise, we'll get ignored again.
It'll stay in the bag.
No, we've just done a version of Lily Marlene, the old Second World War song.
Yeah. Now, I remember it from when I was young.
Very young, you were.
Very,
yeah,
very,
that's
extremely
right.
Young.
When we were young, the
Must
Second
have been
World
about
War
minus 10. Then.
Well, that's right. But the Second World War was reasonably fresh at that stage, wasn't it? When
it
we were young.
It was fresh in our memories when we were young.
Especially when you were young. I mean,
yeah.
I don't remember it particularly, but so we thought, what are the kids nowadays not getting enough of? And they're not getting enough of the Second World War sort of songs,
no,
are they?
Not getting enough war tunes. So we've set that right.
So we're putting.
We've done a sort of a vaguely Pacific sort of rim version with a slightly. Vaguely so Hawaiian country sound to it. So
Hawaiian, Tahitian country, Bavarian.
As again the sort of military orchestral sound of the originals. So
but it is what I think the kids are crying out for nowadays, and there is a
moaning for it.
Great dearth of this kind of stuff on the on MTV.
A lack of war songs on MTV. Anyway, that's what we
blah blah blah. So if you had more questions written on the page, we'd be able to keep talking.
We could keep talking forever, but that we've done the 5 questions. Unless you can. Yeah. Think of something you want to talk about and go on about, rant about.
What sort of questions do they normally ask? Rant or how did you get your name on Dog Trumpet?
Dog Trumpet, that's obvious.
Don't know. Ask me another one.
Found it in the rubbish bin. Come and see the band rather than listening to us sort of waffle on.
And buy our records. We've got 3 terrific records and a 4th coming up with including Lily Marlene. And the rest of it will be original material.
There's only 3 left.
3 left what? 3 what?
3 records. You said we've only got 3 records. We've got 3
Did
records.
I say that?
Yeah, you said we've got 3 records.
Oh, no.
We've actually got about 200.
Well, that's right.
200.
Next time we make a CD, we might only issue 1 copy of it and see what happens. People have got burners.
Makes them really valuable.
Well, it does,
you've only got 1.
Yeah. There's 10 million burnt copies out there.
Yeah.
One
anyway,
original.
We've got to do a sound check.
Didn't make any money out of that one.
So, good night, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. We're off to do a sound check now.
Yes, thank you.
Thanks for listening to our ridiculous waffle.
Question 1. Martin, you, Greedy, and Reg met at art school. Did you ever imagine where this trip would take you in this very successful career?
No, I didn't. But my name's not Martin, it's Bird. I didn't really, no. I didn't think that. I thought that I'd be able to pay for car repairs to my car and maybe get a few chicks and a few free drinks.
Ah.
That's always good.
Yeah, well, it is.
Yes. You've been there, keeping it together on the drums for the band's entire career. What are some of your highlights?
Oh, some of the highlights, playing with Tiny Tim, of course.
And he is?
Oh, and he is dead now.
Oh.
He is tiptoeing through the tulips, but that was a highlight, yes. Other highlights include playing with Men at Work, Cold Chisel and the Angels. And the Radiators as well. A few other highlights. Oh, there's so many highlights. Highlights of my life. Gee, there's too many. I can't think of one.
Think of the one that you wouldn't usually think of.
The highlight of my life well, I'll probably be leaving, won't it? Seeing I've been here so long.
Really?
Well, yeah, something to look forward to, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
That'll be the highlight.
Go to a beach.
I can't do anything else, but I'm too old to retrain.
Yeah.
Would Burger King take me, do you think?
Maybe.
Yeah. But they've never heard of Tiny Tim either, have they? Anyone that works there?
They might have.
They might have, yeah.
If they were like his son or grandson or something.
No, they didn't have any children, mate.
A very not that many torrid, people know about.
Torrid affair with Miss Lizzie, I think it was.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Ask me another question, but I sort of like it.
All right. Well, I've got here, this question three.
Yeah.
What's next?
What's next?
Yeah, for Metal Is Anything.
What's next? Busy's 30th birthday party. We've just been to Coolum. Been to Melbourne recently. After that, I think we're going to go to DY. DY's next.
Melbourne and DY.
Yeah.
Wow.
But we think we might get the Stone support in 2005.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. We're sort of sweating on that.
A long way away.
Well, not really. It's the end of 2003 now. In rock time, it's only like two tours.
Oh, no, yeah.
Two or three tours.
Of course it is.
But really, it is a paid vacation.
Right.
Mm.
Yeah.
You ever thought about being in a band?
No. One-man band.
Never thought about it?
Well, I've thought about being in a one-man band.
Yeah, but that'd be really lonely.
Yeah.
So you join a band because you didn't get some mates. I didn't have any mates until I joined a band. I was really lonely.
Well, if you pretended to be schizophrenic or something, had all your pretend friends all around you, you can hear the music, but no one else can.
Oh, right.
Okay. You can just sing really badly, but your band, who don't exist, can hear it and they like it. So you just keep singing.
I used to be indecisive, but now I'm not so sure.
Really?
Mm.
Wow.
Well, I've got stretch marks on my brain. Just trying to figure out your game. I don't understand the rules. Who is who and whose is whose? But I'm playing just the same. I got a ticket to a place. I'm never sure.
works on my brain. Just try.